right center strategy didn't work! 50 years of failure continues!
Point to Nylander, find Tavares,
Matthews! From John Tavares!
And the Toronto Maple Leafs are going to end 50 years of failure!
Leafs star up forward Austin Matthews' alleged behavior that night in May.
Plan on how to handle the situation, and it's just an errant judgment on my part.
Obviously, I expected it was coming, so.
Is how do they do the Matthews deal? How do they do the Nylander deal? How do they do Marner?
We win a Stanley Cup. The guy gets the game-winning goal, and he says, "Oh no, don't want to sign an extension. Bye, going back to Arizona."
I'm not pussyfooting around like some guys.
Toronto, we are back. Man, it's time for us to head into the year four playoffs where we get to defend our Stanley Cup from year number three as the President's Trophy winning team as well. Hardware stacking up here in the city of Toronto. But now it's time for the year four playoffs. And in round number one, we have the team that stacked their blue line up at the trade deadline, the Carolina Hurricanes. They have eight top four defensemen on this team. I kid you not. So we have the Twitch Scouts in here. It's a very early live stream today. I thought I'd do one for the European fans. So we're going to have a lot of fun. Hopefully we can get past the first round, get past the second round, get back to the Stanley Cup Finals. There's so many storylines available right now. Obviously, Austin Matthews is not in the Stanley Cup playoffs, so we won't have to match up against him. But can we get back to the finals? Can we have a third finals in a row against the Chicago Blackhawks? Oh my God. But first, we got to get by this tough team. The Carolina Hurricanes. So first line, Teravainen, Sebastian Aho, and Andrei Svechnikov. Now, this is 4 years in. These guys are absolute studs. How old are they? Toivo is the oldest one, 29 years of age. Aho, 26. And Svechnikov, 24. So if these guys are a tough team to beat, expect to see them year after year after year. Toivo's a playmaker. Yes, he is. Sebastian Aho, two-way? Yeah. Two ways can act like playmakers, though, in a sniper, so I don't know about that combination. In the new game, I haven't done as much experimenting with chemistry as I'd like to, and I don't know if two-way forwards can slot in instead of power forwards. If they can, that first line could be a plus five. It really could, because the way they're playing in 89 and 91 and then 89, they might have been having some real good regular season, so we got to watch out for that. Second line, you got Sven Barchisi alongside of Martin Necas. Is that how you pronounce his name, Necas? The Twitch scouts will let me know. And Oliver Bjorkstrand, so pretty good 1-2 punch on the second line. Barchisi could be a little bit better, but it's a pretty good top six. There's only one player that doesn't belong there. The other five guys are very, very nice. Third line, you got Andrew Mangiapane, or Mangiapane, however you pronounce it. Vasily Ponomarev and Michael Frolik. Nothing spectacular about that third line. They may simulate well, but it's not jumping out at me. And then the fourth line, you got Brendan Lemieux, Benoit Oliver Garol, and Matt Calvert. Again, Garol's not bad as an 82 overall center fourth line sniper. Center fourth line. What is he, a playmaker? Two-way forward. Sorry. I'm way off with these players. So they have some good center depth. That guy could be better on the third line. But it's really about their top six, isn't it? Their bottom six is nothing to write home about. Defensively, this is where their team is created. Now, the Carolina Hurricanes, in the real world and in this universe, they have a tendency to really target defensemen at the trade deadline. What did they do in the real world this past year? Didn't they go after, like, Brady Shea? Wasn't there another guy they got in there? In this universe, I think in year one or year two, they picked up Nick Leddy for, like, a first at the trade deadline. And this season, they got themselves Aaron Ekblad from the Florida Panthers and Colton Parayko. Sammy Vatanen, was it? Yeah, Shea and Vatanen. There you go. The Twitch scouts are good for something, see? And Colton Parayko goes this year. I was trying to get my hands on Colton Parayko. He would have been perfect. The defensive defenseman could have been the replacement for either Zadorov or even, what's his name? Oh, man, Gavrikov, right? That would have been a huge increase because we know we could have got the plus five, and that turns him into a 90 overall defenseman. But, of course, GM Superman taking his sweet-ass time during the trade deadline. I know, everyone gets pissed off at me for doing that. Ends up losing out, and look at this blue line now. Slavin, Ekblad, Parayko, Gustafsson, Shea, Pesci, and not to mention, they have Aiden Fleury and Jake Bean. So even if I get, like, to their blue line and injure one, injure two, they still have, they have eight, like I said, they have eight top four defensemen. And they have a very good top six. They got to get a goaltender. Who do they have in the net again? It was Grubauer, 84 overall. I mean, it's not bad. It's what we have. But when I'm just thinking about asset management and my blueprint, they got two defenders that they're not even using. Oh my God, I'd flip those two guys, maybe even with a first, and bring in like an 88 overall goaltender, and they have everything. Or even if Grubauer is simulating well, you could beef up that third line, right? Like, there's a lot they could do there, but that's the decision that they've made. They want that depth on the blue line. So that's the team that we're going up against in round number one. I will show you guys your Toronto Maple Leafs, who arguably are a better team than the team that won the Stanley Cup last season. Now, Phil Kessel's dropped to an 83 with the plus five during the regular season. Quick sim, he played fine. You take a look at these numbers. Hang on a second. If you take a look at these numbers, he had 40 goals in 82 games played for 87 points, a plus 33. But now that we're in the real-time sim, is that 83 overall going to be a little bit too low? McKinnon and Marner are going to be fine, and they should help raise him up. And I know that Phil can still score, but is he going to be a liability defensively now? Because that's the thing that older players suffer with. It's the speed and the defensive categories. They can still score, but they do get scored upon. And I just wonder with the real-time sim, if chemistry doesn't kick in, are we going to run into problems right there? I can always mix and match, but we will keep an eye on the defensive tendencies of Phil Kessel. Second line has been our best line the last two trips to the Stanley Cup Finals, led by this man, John Tavares. I need a little bit more out of John this year without Austin Matthews. I don't know how Nathan MacKinnon is going to simulate. I'm hoping for a lot, but we're going to have to wait and see. We know that John Tavares can simulate well, though, so come on, John. Get going. Nick Ritchie, Robertson, and Puljujarvi. Don't know what to expect out of this third line. I like the base numbers, but the chemistry is not there. It's better than Carolina's, but again, I don't know what to expect. They could be good. They could be a bunch of bums. And then the same with the fourth line. During the regular season with the plus fives, they're good. Is this going to be a liability, though, for us? Because in the past, we've had two-way forwards. Didn't we even have like a sniper or a power forward on that fourth line? So we'll keep an eye on the fourth line, because if they're not playing well, I can always bring up Grigorenko and Getzlaf and slot them right in there alongside of Michael Ferland, right? I will make the moves if I need to. Defensively, we're going back with the same lineups that we had last year and the year before that. We're running with our best overall defenseman on the first line, getting all the ice time. We're getting a second line with a plus five chemistry, and then Shillington was Zadorov on the third line, and we have Captain Keith Yandel as our defensive substitution if I need to. Now, I was also listening to the Twitch scouts, and they decided that we want the plus five chemistry with the power play instead of Morgan Rielly and Liljegren. If we notice that our power play is not succeeding, we can swap out Warren Fogel and swap out Nick Ritchie for Liljegren and Rielly and just beef up the overall, because if the chemistry is not working, all right? We also went with our main guns on the penalty kill, stacking McKinnon, Marner, Nylander, and Tavares. And the fact that this coach actually likes playmakers and snipers and offensive defensemen on the penalty kill, it works out for us. Oh, and last but not least, automated goalie rotations are off, and the Twitch scouts have decided that Marc-Andre Fleury, the goaltender that delivered the Stanley Cup for us last season, is going to at least get the start in the playoffs. But we're going to make that switch to Korpisalo if Fleury's overall starts to affect him. He is 83 compared to last year where, what was he, 86, 87? So that's a big drop off. Okay. So, enough's enough. Here we go. We are champions of the playoffs. We are champions of the regular season. But that could all be erased in four bad games here. We don't have Austin Matthews. I feel like we have a good team. But with the new coach, with the Grinders, I don't know. And Kessel on the first line, I don't know, man. Carolina's always been a pain in the ass team for me. So, here we go. Simulation. Game number one, round number one, we have started. The Twitch scouts have been engaged. Let us get these playoffs underway, Europe. And, oh my God, not good. The second shot of the game, Sven Barchesi is going to score a 5-on-3 power play for Toronto. And there you go, Phil Kessel. He scores on the power play after the 5-on-3. So, what is that, three minor penalties so far in this game? And we're only in the first period. The Carolina Hurricanes are undisciplined so far to start this. Now, we do have the shot advantage. I wouldn't look too much into that, though, because what was it? We had all those power plays, right? So we've just had a lot of opportunities to shoot. And Nathan MacKinnon, he's going to score his first career NHL playoff goal with the Toronto Maple Leafs, followed up by William Nylander and John Tavares. There you go, boys. Yeah, you got the emotes. You got the Kessel emote. You got the Nylander emote. Tavares and MacKinnon. MacKinnon, baby, that's two. So this Toronto Maple Leaf squad, if you look at the regular season numbers, holy shit, we were a team that was able to keep the puck out of the net, but we also still maintain this ability to explode at any time. Now, they have three goals as well, but look at this. Nathan MacKinnon, in his first playoff game with his new team, the Toronto Maple Leafs, the man comes in and gets himself a solid hat trick by the end of the second period. Oh, my God. And what are we calling him? The Big Mac. Nathan MacKinnon, good job. All right, so let's not go crazy here. Their blue line, is it just their goaltender? See, having a good blue line, it helps. But if you don't have a team that can score and if you don't have a goalie, it's not going to be the end-all be-all. It's not the key to keeping the puck out of the net. I also think that having a good blue line generates offense for you in this game. And this is why our team can just explode, man. Riley and Liljegren on that first line with no chemistry, but then Bear and Gavrikov on that second. And the Toronto Maple Leafs just dominate the Carolina Hurricanes 7-3. That's what I like to see. The defending Stanley Cup champions, the defending President's Trophy team, just come in and whoop the Carolina Hurricanes' ass. See the third line? See what I mean about this third line? I don't know what to make of them. Don't know what. Richie only played 8:35. Robertson. Is Robertson going to come back injured? And let's see what Marc-Andre did. 9:09. Yeah, it's a good. You know what? It's a fine playoff game. On 33 shots, he allowed 3 goals. I'll take that in a playoff game. That's fine. Don't worry about it. Robertson, were you injured? Sim to next game. I mean, he's getting no power play or penalty kill time, so that makes sense. Yeah, and Richie and Fogler on the power play. And Puljuharvi. I wonder why Puljuharvi had so much. Oh, well. All right. Well, we won game one. Nathan MacKinnon, 4 points. And you know what? That's going to be even bigger when you think about it. Because the last two playoff runs when we went to the Stanley Cup Finals, John Tavares on the second line has been our best player. Matthews was around point per game, but it was more his defensive ability. If MacKinnon is freaking 4 point per game kind of thing, and Tavares still plays the way he did, forget about it, man. We have too much offense. Ethan Bear ties up the game in the first period here. Giroux, was that guy their fourth line center? I believe so. Their fourth line center opening up the goal scoring. Giroux, whatever his damn name is. I always screw that. I look at it and I see Giroux, but it ain't Giroux. And Ethan Bear scores for the Toronto Maple Leafs. So out shooting them again. Good. I was just about to say their top six has been silent. And then boom, Neches. Oh, man. Yo, dude, Nathan MacKinnon might be legit. I didn't know because he's a playmaker, right? But I'm forgetting about Austin Matthews real quickly right here. Now, in a game where they have all these goals, which line are they scoring on? Are they scoring on the third line? Because I really felt like with Phil Kessel on that first line, our top pairings are going to be susceptible to allowing goals. It's just the way it is with older players. I'd rather have Phil on my third line with a +5 chemistry, but just the way it is, he gets the +5 on the first line. So we'll see. Third period underway. Come on now, Toronto. You have one goal in you here? Come on. You're just going to get shut out. Oh, my God. And the Carolina Hurricanes. Now, they're going to get right back in this series with a 4-2. Yo, 5-2. And that was an empty netter there at the end. So, Marc-Andre Fleury allows 4, but our Toronto Maple Leafs only score 2 after a game where we got 7 all over the place. Okay, so let's take a look at these stats and see why we didn't win that game. Marner, see what I mean? I knew it. Marner, MacKinnon, Kess, see what I mean? And they got a goal as well. And it wasn't even a power play goal. This is my problem with a guy like Kessel on the first line. That's rough. Zadorov, Bear. All right, and what about Korpisalo? Fleury in 2 games has not played. Yeah, you're right. Should we give Korpisalo a chance? Twitch scouts. Or do I give him? Because that's one bad game. I said that game one was deep. Oh, hang on a second. Gavrikov's gone down with a sore foot. Let me just replace player for right now. Let me just sim to the next one. Sim to the next game. Because I don't want to be jumping all over the place with line changes. One more game. Corpy, one more game. I like the idea of one more game as well. But I got to go back. I got to go check Gavrikov. Hang on a second. So that's going to be Captain Keith Yandle who goes in. So we're going to have 3 offensive defensemen. Captain Keith. So I'm going to have to split up these lines here. We're going to go Riley and Bear. Shillington and Liljegren. and then Yandle and Zadorov, okay? So we're going to split up the defensive core just so we get some... I don't want to put two offensive defensemen together. Corpy is the move. All right, so the Twitch scouts are saying Corpy. Fleury, you haven't had a great first two games here. An 890 with a goals against a 351. He's 39 years of age. I have to be able to make these changes. And Phil Kessel, let me just look at the first line, because that first game, they did amazing. Like, if they score all those goals like they did in the first game, it doesn't matter what they do. Yeah, freaking hell, four goals. All right, I'm going to give him another shot because the second line is doing fine. And I don't want to move up Tavares there. I will if I have to, but I don't want to have to do it. What about the fourth line? No, they're doing fine. Fourth line's not hurting us. All right, so with Gavrikov out, we've made some changes. Ryan Getzlaf, people are saying to bring in. The fourth line hasn't been a hindrance yet, guys. Hang on. We're Getzlaf over Robertson. Hang on. We've lost one game, and you guys are already going off saying to make changes. Let's just take it one step at a time here, okay? Game three, we're going south to Carolina, baby. All these damn blue liners are making it tough for us. So here we go. In Carolina for game number three. Can the Leafs get or reclaim the lead that they first had in this series? No. Look at this. Fourth line left wing. Brendan Lemieux scoring on Jonas Korpisalo. Followed up, though, by Ethan Bear. Ethan Bear, two games in a row now with the opening goal for the Toronto Maple Leafs. So where's the offense been? The defense, I mean, we only had two goals in the last game. So two of our last three goals have come from Ethan Bear. What the hell is going on? So two goals on six shots against Korpisalo. So you guys making the call for Korpisalo. It doesn't seem like it's worked just yet. Although we could still shut it down for the rest of the game. There you go, Nathan MacKinnon. First line. Come through for me, buddy. Oh, yes. Mitch Marner. First line. Oh, yes. Robertson. People saying to take him out for Ryan Getzlaf. This is the thing about this Leaf team you have to understand. Game two, we lost. Fair enough. You just got to put it behind you. We have the ability to score. We're always going to have the ability to score. So ultimately, it comes down to, in a seven-game series, can we score four games out of seven, you know? And then the games that we do score, can we win? When we lose those games, like 5-6-5, like if we lose this game, that's a game that we should have won. We got to find a way to clamp it down here in the third. Come on now, boys. Korpisalo, I need you. I need you, Corpse. This is the game where you got to step up and just shut the door in the third. Andrei Svechnikov ties the... Korpisalo's gone. He's garbage! Oh, what a third period falter right there by Jonas Korpisalo. Three goals in a row. Fantastic. Oh my god. All right, Korpisalo's not going in. So the Toronto Maple Leafs all of a sudden are in big trouble. What happened? Game one, we were so dominant. And then it just all... Okay, what? Let me see the minuses. Who's the minuses? Nylander. The second line, Nylander, Fogle, Paquette. All right. Getzlaf, let's go, buddy. That grinder line is not getting it done for me in the real-time sim. The real-time sim is different. It's pissing me off. All right, so let's go to our edit lines and see what we can do. Should have left Flower in. Hey, we made one change. I can go Flower. We're only down 2-1 in the series. Don't worry. This ain't over. This is far from over. We lose the next game, and it's still not over, but we're in trouble. So this first line, I'm going to leave. We got to get Phil going somehow, though. Phil ain't going. Tavares, you guys drop off after that game? Tavares got 6 points in three games played. No, keeping all that. Stack the power play? We scored in that first game, though. You think? Okay, yeah, I could do that. Riley and Liljegren? Okay, good idea. Richie Robertson and Pulya Harvey, Cedric Paquette. All right, so Giovanni Smith, you're coming off. Giovanni, we're replacing you with Mikhail Grigorenko. All right, this is what I kept Grigorenko for. Cedric Paquette, you're coming off. Ryan Getzlafian. All right, Getzlaf, where can you play? Third line? Get you going at all? Richie's probably better on the third line, to be honest. Yeah, he is. So Getzlaf, you're playing fourth line ice time. Grigorenko, can I move you anywhere? Yeah, we're suffering. I have a wild idea. Ferland, what have you been doing so far? You've been alright. I just don't need a grinder with a minus one on that fourth line. I got an idea. Tom, for some AHL support, baby. This is why I got you guys. To hell with your AHL playoffs. Korshkov, no, I don't need Korshkov. I need a playmaker. Patan. Playmaker. It's your time, buddy. It's your time. Ooh, what about, wait a minute. What about Dansk? Playmaker. bringing him up. The kid is, the rookie is getting his first chance to play in the NHL playoffs. Let's go, Dansk. All right, my stud draft pick that the fans found for us last year. Dansk is coming up. Dansk. No, because I need a playmaker. And I think he works out in the bottom six. Hang on, Dansk. I think he works out in the bottom six. Danskovian. Oh, no, that's Giovanni. Dansk. Bang! This is why. He's my bottom six playmaker of the future. He's beautiful. All right, Nicholas Dansk. Okay. Building one step at a time here. What else can I do? If I go like you there. No, can't get a plus three. No, Robertson's the guy in the third line. We committed to that. All right, so this is why I kept my boys. Just in case, we have Getzlaf, Grigorenko, and Dansk, the rookie, getting the chance to play. The reason I'm giving this guy the go-ahead is because look what he did in the AHL. He's a bona fide player, and for some reason, he's already better than Giovanni Smith. So let's completely revamp our fourth line, get the veteran Getzlaf and Grigorenko going. Let's try to get some more support. I'm going to leave Kessel there, Fogel, Richie, and all. They got to stay the same, although this is starting to piss me off. No, I gotta go back with Liljegren and Riley. Those two ended up working out for me. I need Bear and Zadorov then. Plus five? Yeah, and then... Mother of Christ, that hurts. I don't have Mertensen. Shit. Gotta bring up somebody else. Roster moves. Bringing up a defenseman. Who we bringing up? I gotta get somebody to play on the third line. Alongside of Shillington. I need somebody. Who are we going? Kral, Kokkonen, Rassinen. Shillington would be... I don't think I can get a plus. Oh, I can. Christensen's not good enough to play in the playoffs. Who do we want? Kral? It was Kokkonen, wasn't it? It was Kok. Yeah, it was the Kok. All right, Kokkonen, get your ass up here. And I got to send down somebody. Captain Keith Yandel. No, I'll send down a forward. Hang on. Yeah, because I already brought up somebody else. Let me send down Giovanni. All right, Giovanni, there you go. I'm not going to lose him to waivers, don't worry. So, Kokkonen up for Giovanni Smith. There you go. Yeah, because, I mean, we're on the brink here. We have to get these wins. So, the AHL squad, I'm just going to go best lines of the AHL squad. There you go, AHL. And the NHL squad, I got Getzlaf, I got Grigorenko, I got Dansk in there. Defensively, Riley, Liljegren, Bear, Zadorov, Shillington, Captain Keith Yandel, you're going to come out. We're going to throw in Kokkonen. All right. I know he's only 77 overall, but I get that plus one instead. And I don't need a minus three. It's way too much. All right. So that one's tough. That one is tough. Four-man power play. Now, you guys said stack the power play. So Warren Fogle's coming off the power play. We're going to go with Morgan Riley. And the second line power play, we're going to take Nick Ritchie off. We're going to go with Timothy Liljegren. So we're losing some chemistry there, but we got better defenders in. The penalty kill, we're going to leave stacked. And is that pretty much it? Was there anything else I was forgetting? Bear, Riley, Shillington, Liljegren, penalty kill. Hell no, that was a mistake. That was almost a big mistake. Hang on. Kokkonen is not on the penalty kill. I gotta get Zadorov, you're already in there. Shillington. Yeah, I might as well just get Shillington or Bear. There you go, Shillington, Zadorov. Liljegren, Riley, Kokkonen, Zadorov. No, let me get Ethan Bear in there. I know he's an offensive defenseman, but still, 83 overall is better than the other guy. All right. So there you go. And we're going back with Marc-Andre Fleury as the goaltender. So a lot of micromanaging right there, but the Toronto Maple Leafs are down 2-1 in the series, and they've got to make some changes. So with our new squad, Ryan Getzlaf, Grigorenko, and Dansk on the fourth line, baby. Come on, Dansk. I'm hoping for a good game from you. Game 4 in Carolina. The Leafs are down 2-1. Come on. And we got Marc-Andre Fleury back in the net because Jonas Korpisalo is just not good enough. Both my goaltenders might not be good enough. I need to reinvest in like an 86 plus overall goaltender, right? With the new stats in this game. No! Sven Barchesi is going to open up the goal scoring for the Carolina Hurricanes. You hate to see it. We are not getting any goaltending. Remember last year and the year before that even, we would get through these games, these first periods at least, not allowing a damn 2-0 for the Carolina Hurricanes. Yeah, you know what? When I compare my team last year to this year, we certainly have what we need up front and on the blue line. We don't have that fourth line. And also, Marc-Andre Fleury is not 86, 87 overall anymore. This is hurting us. But where's the offense as well? God damn. Second period. Come on now, Leafs. You got to find a way through. Ryan Getzlaf, John Tavares. Good old Canadian boys. You can trust in them. Getzlaf's first game of 2024, 2023. And it's a big one. Beautiful job, Ryan. Should have been playing you the entire year. Yes, Ethan Bear, his third goal in three consecutive games, and they've all been big ones. You know, he's been the one to get us back. Oh my God, Calvert with a ball breaker of a goal. 12 seconds left in the second period. The Leafs are up by one, and they end up losing that lead. It's all tied up going into the third period. So, I mean, if we lose this, we're down 3-1 in this series. It might as well be over. Come on, you guys got to find a way to win this one. All right, yeah. The last game, Korpisalo dropped it in the third. Fleury, buddy, Fleury. If Fleury drops it here, I'm just not getting goaltending. It's as simple as that. Here we go. Third period underway. Oh, my God. Neches again gets the go-ahead goal in the third period. We're just not getting goaltending. It's as simple as that. Power play for the Carolina Hurricanes. Come on, Leafs. Why are we taking penalties late, you idiots? Come on. Ah, we're not going to tie it up. No. And the Toronto Maple Leafs, after winning the President's Trophy, defending the Stanley Cup, and after winning Game 1, we've lost 3 in a row. How? Toronto stats. I just can't. Oh, we can't get going. Who is a minus in this game? Only minus ones. Tavares. Oh, my God. All right. So, I have nothing else to give. We've got to just stack. We've just got to stack. I got to link Tavares and MacKinnon and Marner. It's as simple as that. Phil Kessel on that first line is an 83 overall. He's just not getting it done in the playoffs. Let's see. He's got one goal in four games now. He's just not getting it done. All right, so we're stacking the pack. Marner, MacKinnon, Tavares. Holy crap. Yep, we're doing it. Second line, I got to get Willie Nee as my second line center. Kessel, you could play the wing. Fogle, is there any other sniper that could go in there that gives me the +3? Robertson, Grigorenko. Give me Puljujarvi. Let's move Puljujarvi up. Grigorenko, Kessel down to the third line. You know what? Let's move Grigorenko up. Kessel down to the fourth line. All right. I gotta put the veterans down here. Kessel with Dansk and Getzlaf. Dansk, 2 games played. He had an assist, baby. Beautiful, Dansk. Good job. All right. So, did he play 2 games in these playoffs? Hang on, playoff stats. Oh, he played 1. Oh, that's why. 2 games. It combines the two. I see. So, oh, he didn't have an assist here. Shit. All right. So, we're going to stack down there. Riley, Liljegren, Kakanen. Do we have Gavrikov back? Gavrikov's still injured. That Gavrikov injury really hurts. I just don't know. Should I be stacking Bear up on that first line with, you know what? I'm going to try Zadorov with Bear on the first line with the chemistry. I gotta shake it up a little bit. And then Liljegren and Riley on the second. Actually, you know what? I'm going to try something new here. I'm going to try something new because I know I can do this. Yeah. Shillington and Liljegren on the first with a +3. So I'm getting Lily at the +3 and then Riley and Bear at the +1, Zadorov and Kakanen. Okay? And then if I got Zadorov down here, I don't need Kakanen. I can go with Captain Keith and get a +5? +1. Yeah, that's the problem. +5 there. Zadorov, but then Riley gets less time on ice. No. All right, so I'm going to leave you. I'm going to leave Captain Keith in there instead of Kakanen, just because the veteran leadership. We'll see what he can do. All right, so I got all my veterans in there. My scratch players now are Ferland, Paquette, and Kakanen. All my grinders. And the goaltender situation, Marc-Andre Fleury's done nothing for us. What do I do? You got to give me a goalie to run with. Marc-Andre Fleury, 886. Korpisalo, 8. Okay, it's Fleury. Fuck you, Korpisalo. Garbage. All right, it's Marc-Andre Fleury. If we're going to go out, we're going to go out with our top gun that got us the Stanley Cup last year. So here it is, ladies and gentlemen. I have no other answers for us. The Toronto Maple Leafs are suffering. We can't find any goaltending, and our offense has shriveled up after that first game where we exploded. Actually, I should take that back. Our offense has still been there. We just haven't been we were the best defensive team in the NHL during the regular season. 7-3, 5-2, all right, but we got 4 goals that game we lose. We got 3 goals that game we lose. It's just, we're not getting any goaltending. 3 goals against, 5 goals against, 7 goals against, 4 goals against. Where's the shutout? Where's the 1 goal against? Where's the 2 goal against game, you know? Nowhere to be found. So here it is. AHL goalie? No, we just got to hope for some good simulation. It's their blue line, man. The Carolina Hurricanes with their blue line. The storybook ending for the Toronto Maple Leafs is coming to an end. You know the snake Auston Matthews is laughing his ass off somewhere. He's hoping for this. I'm glad. Have fun on the golf course. We'll be joining you soon. Power play for the Toronto Maple Leafs goes nowhere. I stacked the power play. I listened to the Twitch scouts, you bastards. 5-on-3. What are we doing? Willie Knee, baby. William Nylander, our second line center. Good job, buddy. All right, so William Nylander's got to hold down that second line all by himself. John Tavares with MacKinnon and Marner. If you guys don't score any goals, I don't know what to say. You're a plus five, and you're all freaking 90-something overall. Come on. There it is! Captain Johnny T playing the left wing on that first line, baby. We can do it. We can come back. Halfway through the game, the Toronto Maple Leafs have a 2-0 lead. They're on the penalty kill, though. Good kill, boys. Good kill. So it might have been, yeah, Phil Kessel on that first line, which is a good indication going into next year. You know, the real-time sim and the quick-time sim are just not the same. But hang on, one step at a time here. So we are up by 2 going into the third period. Can we maintain this lead? Oh, my. Shorthanded goal for Michael Frolik. Oh, just have the season end. John Tavares, though, he gets the insurance marker for his Toronto Maple Leafs, his second goal of the game. My God, man, a shorthanded goal. If they come back in this now. Come on, power play. End it. End it. Ice it. In front of your home ice fans. Give them at least one more win to go home with. And both of our freaking goals. Look at that. Right on top of the freaking net. Yes. All right. Good job, Johnny T. All right. So the first line and the second line both showed up. William Nylander, the second line center. John Tavares, my first line left wing. We stack the lines and it ends up working out for us. Let's see the Toronto stats. Tavares a +2. Nylander a +2. Zadorov a +1. Who's a minus? Bear, Riley, Kessel. Fucking Kessel. You garbage, Kessel. What happened? Last year, you were my stud on the second line. He's lost his legs. He's lost his legs. He's lost his playoff legs. All right, all right. We're alive. We're alive. 3-1, remember. We had that horrible experience against the Chicago Blackhawks. We're up 3-2 against the Edmonton Oilers in the Stanley Cup Finals 2 years ago. 3-1 is nothing. All right, we can come back, baby, in Carolina for game number 6. This reminds me. You know, holy shit. This is like 2002, the Eastern Conference Finals all over again. I mean, it's round one, but the Leafs won game one. Then we lost 3 in a row. We won game 5, and then we lost game 6 in overtime to the Carolina Hurricanes. Could we force the game 7? The game 7 that we couldn't force in 2002? Oh. All right, here we go. Game 6. The President's Trophy winning Leafs, the defending champion Toronto Maple Leafs, holding on to their season lives. Power play. They cannot convert, though. You hate to see it. Another power play. Come on, Toronto. You hate to see it. You freaking idiots on the power play. Our power play has been god-awful in these playoffs so far as well, boys. That first game, that's it. And Jesse Puljujarvi playing alongside of William Nylander on the second line, scoring. Fucking ball buster goal scored again by Brendan Lemieux. 45 seconds left in the first period, and he ties the game up. You hate to see it. All right, second period underway. Come on now, Leafs. Find a way to keep the puck out of the net. That's the key. All right, we know we can explode, but we're just falling behind in these games. All the time, we're trailing. Warren Fogle, way to go. Good old Ontario boy. What a contract. He's almost making like the league minimum. It's great. 2-1 lead. Come on. Marc-Andre, no ball buster goal. What the hell? Yes, Mikhail Grigorenko on the fourth line chipping in. All of a sudden, the Leafs have made a few line changes and the defense has come back to them. The defense has come right back to them. They're keeping the puck out of the net all of a sudden. Third period. Underway. The Leafs, can they force a game 7 here in Carolina for game 6? They have a 2-goal advantage. 14 minutes left. Holy shit. Come on now, Toronto. We are the veterans of this league. We are the potential dynasty. We could have beat Chicago 2 years ago and had back-to-back Stanley Cups. This is our third year in a row. We're not letting it slip between our fingers. Game 7. Game 7, ladies and gentlemen. The Toronto Maple Leafs have forced a Game 7 in round number 1 after being down 3-1 in the series. So we did it. We did it right back. And you know what? This is the first time since like Chicago in year 2 where we have faced elimination. If you remember the Stanley Cup playoff run last year, we didn't have to face... Oh, Gavrikov is back! Yes! Gavrikov makes it back. All right. So now I got to send somebody down. Kokkonen, thank you very much for your support, but got to send you down, buddy. All right, yes. Wait, do I leave the lines, though? Shit, what do I do? We just won. Oh, no. No, I got to leave the lines. Captain Keith. No, you got to leave the lines. You got to leave the line. Yeah. You're 2-0. You got to leave the lines. Captain Keith, whatever, even though he's a -1, for me to get the plus fives, ever since I moved Shillington and Liljegren on the first, you know what? Do not touch it. Do not touch it. These players have done enough to deserve the chance. Yeah, I agree, boys. I agree. We're not touching it. So here it is. Just look at the last two games. 3-1 victory, 3-1 victory. I mean, that's the kind of defensive production or lack of production for the Carolina Hurricanes that I'm looking for, right? So I'm not touching a damn thing. So here it is. It comes down to game 7 of round number 1 in year 4. The Toronto Maple Leafs defending their Stanley Cup, defending their President's Trophy up against the Carolina Hurricanes. They force the game 7. Who's going to step up in this game 7? Is it going to be the young Canes with the future ahead of them or the Dynasty Leafs? Are they going to continue this march that they've been on the last 3 years? Here we go. You stupid piece of shit, Marc-Andre Fleury. The second shot of the game, you allow Brett Pesce to blast one home. Power play for the Leafs goes nowhere. 10 minutes through the first period, and the Carolina Hurricanes have that 1-0 lead. We're in Toronto. We have home ice advantage. Do not let this be the story of year number 4. Score some freaking... Yeah. Jesse, pull my freaking Harvey. Good job, buddy. All right, that's a ball buster of a goal for the Carolina Hurricanes. We deserve that after all the ball buster goals that they've scored. 10 seconds left in the first period. The man comes through for us. Okay. Everything is going our way. Look at the shot. Just keep playing. Just keep playing. Second period. Underway. The Leafs have the Hurricanes right where they want them. The line changes. We've been simulating much better. Power play, please. Oh, we had the power play advantage. But Philip Grubauer and that blue line, the defensive core, the penalty kill, the Carolina Hurricanes, they're good enough to hold off the power play specialists of the Toronto Maple Leafs. 2 minutes left. The Big Mac! Oh my God! Nathan MacKinnon scores on Philip Grubauer to give the Leafs a 2-1 lead going into the third period. Game 5, we won 3-1. Game 6, we won 3-1. Game 7, we're up 2-1 going into the third period. I don't know what line changes we made, but things are working. Come on, boys. Third period, underway. Oh my God, the Big Mac! He gives us the insurance marker! Oh, Ethan Bear, the good old Canadian boys! The Toronto Maple Leafs have stormed back from being down 3-1 in the series, and now have a 4-1 lead in Game 7. Power play halfway through. We're gonna do it. Ethan Bear again. That's like his fifth goal of the freaking round. The Toronto Maple Leafs, they explode, baby. And we're going back to the second round. Come on, boys. Get on your feet. It's victory here in Toronto. Boom. Okay, so round one comes to an end. And your Toronto Maple Leafs have stormed back from a 3-1 series deficit. It was clearly the line changes. It's not even coincidence. I had a feeling that Phil Kessel was going to struggle on that first line when we got to the playoffs. He started the year at 85 overall. I thought he even jumped to 86 overall, or maybe it was 84 to 85. But now that we're in the playoffs, he's 83. It's not good enough, man. And we saw it. Like, defensively, we were getting whooped. But the last three games, when I made those line changes, 3-1 victory, 3-1 victory, 7-2 victory. All of a sudden, the best defensive team in the NHL showed up again. Now, there's also something else that happened. Marc-Andre Fleury played great, but I found a line combination that is only exclusive to Timothy Liljegren. And it seemed like it worked. So if you look at Timothy Liljegren, right? He's the two-way defender with those kind of chemistry. Pinch balanced. The other two-way defender that we have is Morgan Rielly. He only works on the third line, right? So we can get him the plus chemistry on the third line, or we can get him a plus one on the first line with Ethan Bear. But because Liljegren can play in the first line, you pair him alongside of an offensive defenseman who can also play in the first line, and you actually get a plus three. It's impossible for Rielly to get a plus three there. So we don't get the plus five, but we got one of our 88 overall two-way defenders getting max ice time with that plus three. And if chemistry matters, then there you go. And then you got Ethan Bear alongside of Morgan Rielly with the plus one. So it's actually not that bad. Now, do we take out Zadorov and go back with Gavrikov? Or do I just leave the lines the way they are? I mean, Gavrikov is still injured. Captain Keith Yandel's a plus two in 4 games played. What do you guys think? Leave? You're muted? No, I'm not muted. Shut up. Don't worry. Don't worry, boys. I'm on to it. I recognize the Twitch scout names that I can trust. So it seems like we are just going to leave the lines the way they are. And I want to show you guys something right now. The potential rivalry remains. The Carolina Hurricanes almost destroyed an amazing Stanley Cup final. But look over there in the West. Chicago Blackhawks have defeated the Edmonton Oilers in 6 games. Could you imagine if we have the third year in a row, Chicago versus Toronto in the Stanley Cup Finals? Oh my God, it would be unbelievable. Now we don't have, they don't have Kane, we don't have Matthews, so both teams lost like their the face of their franchise, so be it, right? Or face their franchise, so to speak, so be it. What the hell was that? I don't even know. But to get there, we still have to get through 2 more teams, right? So one step at a time. So let's advance the day and get to round number 2. And once again, we had the Tampa Bay Lightning. Now, here's the thing. The Tampa Bay Lightning have been a team that we've dominated the last 2 years, right? Tampa, they have a very good team. But for some reason, during year 2 and year 3, we simulated very well during the second round of the playoffs. It was Marc-Andre Fleury. Marc-Andre Fleury plays well. Oh my God. Washington is out. Washington with Kane and Taves and Ovechkin and Samsonov and Carlson, they are out. So we are not going to have to face off against the Washington Capitals. We may have a rematch against the Philadelphia Flyers in the conference finals. Oh yeah, it's shaping up. Now we got the Tampa Bay Lightning though. But you know what? I mean, I know they got a good team. They are getting older though. And Steven Stamkos by year 4. No, he's probably still good. A few lines. He's not like the real world Steven Stamkos, where in 4 years he's probably going to be retired just because of the amount of injuries the guy has. Yeah, he's 88 at 34 years of age. Oh, never mind. He has started to drop off. So he's dropping off a little bit, but they still have Cirelli. They have Braden Point, and they have Nikita Kucherov. So the combination of Point and Kucherov, but I've said this last year. I thought that they would have a much better team last year and the year before that, and they didn't simulate very well. So, okay, interesting. Second line, they got Andre Palat, Steven Stamkos, and Marcus Sorensen. So it could be a good chemistry line if chemistry plays a part in the real-time sim. I don't know. Third line, you got Yanni Gourde playing the center position alongside of Matthew Joseph and Boris Kachuk. 82, 83, and an 80 overall. That's pretty good. Fourth line, you got Tyler Johnson, Chalapik, and Taylor Radish. Yeah, they got a deep team here. They still have those studs up front in Braden Point and Kucherov. Even Stamkos at 88 overall. Like when you look at Phil Kessel was still capable of putting up those points, but the overall number wasn't there for the real-time sim. And Steven Stamkos, he's still an 88 overall, so he'll still be able to get the goals during the quick-time sim, but during the real-time sim, he's still going to be effective, okay? So their forward core is good, and they have the superstars, and there you go, Victor Hedman. You know, I was going to say that new draft pick or that prospect that I want to go after, the defenseman, is like Victor Hedman. Victor Hedman is one of a kind. 6'6", 223. That guy is only 6'2", the Lundstrom guy. This guy is a stud, and he's still got his exact elite. Yeah, so they have the stud defenseman on the blue line. 91 overall, Victor Hedman. Playing alongside of Mikhail Sergachev, they have Cal Foote and Ryan Graves, Ryan McDonough, and Jan Ruta. So they still have that deep blue line. They have the deep team. The deep team with the studs up front, the studs on the blue line, and Vasilevsky still in his 20s. Vasilevsky, 29 years of age. He has dropped off, though. 88. Oh, they got DiPietro as their bat. They got everything. The Tampa Bay Lightning just have an incredible freaking team here, man, from top to bottom. Their franchise, their roster, it's fantastic. So they're a team to worry about without a shadow of a doubt. Power play, they can explode for offense. They have the goaltender. The only thing that I have in my favor is the fact that we've simulated very well against them the last 2 years. And also, the lines that we have, the last 3 games, you know, 1 goal against, 1 goal against, 2 goals against, was it? Like, we've been keeping the puck out of the net again. Marc-Andre Fleury's playing well. We have our team. Like, I don't know. Going into it, I'm confident. So, enough talk. Let's start up round number 2 up against the Tampa Bay Lightning, shall we? Alrighty. And keep an eye on the Chicago Blackhawks over there in the Western Conference, because I'm telling you, that is the story. If we can get back to the Stanley Cup Finals and face off against them again, whoo-hoo-hoo, that will be so nice. So here we go. A 5-on-3 power play to start the game. Tampa Bay pissed off. And Nathan MacKinnon is going to score on that power play to open up the goal scoring. Followed up, though, by Braden Point. So both teams, their first line center, both scoring power play goals. And the game is all tied up at one. Shots are even. Score is even. Teams are even. Series should be even. Yeah, this. Oh, man. What is today's live stream with ball buster goals? I got to come up with like a ball buster emo because this is getting ridiculous. 20 seconds left and Nikita Kucherov is going to score. So scary. Because in the last 2 years where we've been able to beat them, their top players, Kucherov and Point, and even Stamkos, have not been able to show up and score. The first three goals that Tampa Bay scores in the first 40 minutes, 30 minutes by the way, come from Braden Point, Kucherov, and Stamkos. And then they get the fourth by Yanni Gord. Yep, this is going to be dangerous. If they score, we're in trouble. And there you go, Ryan Getzlaf. Get us back in this game. We can still win this game. I know they got Vasilevsky in the net, but our team can explode. I don't care which team it is. We can explode for three. We've done it before. In previous playoff rounds, we've done it before. Third period in Toronto. Game number one. Come on now, Leafs. You can do it. 10 minutes left. I don't think they're going to do it. No. Vasilevsky's too good. Shit. All right, so game number one looks like it's going to go to the Tampa Bay Lightning. They end the game with like a long major. It looks like a Leaf player just wanted to get a quick shot in there. And yeah, game one goes 5-2 to the Tampa Bay Lightning. So we lose game number one. Let's take a look at these stats. See who did what. See who was a minus. Minus two to Liljegren and Shillington. So just as I was talking up those two defenders. Okay, so I'm not going to make any changes. It's one game. We were in it until that ball buster of a goal at the end of the first period. So I'm not going to make any changes. I still like Liljegren and Shillington up there. But I want to see if that continues. If not, I might have to pair Riley with Liljegren again just so that they can match up against Hedman and what's it called? Sergachev. Fix the power play. Fix the penalty kill. One game. Let's just, because remember the one bad game or the first game against Carolina and then all of a sudden I started to play like shit. If we lose again in similar fashion, 4-1, 6-3, 5-2, then yeah, we can make some changes. But let's just see. All right, game two in Toronto. We're not making any line changes. I like the way, after all, these lines are now 3-1. They won three in a row. We were due for a loss, right? So let's just see. Power play for Toronto. And you guys were saying to change the power play. Yeah, might want to do it. Another power play for Toronto. Oh, yeah. All right. What do you guys think we should do for the power play? Stack the first line. Another power play. 0-3. Yikes. All right. So the Twitch scout's saying that we should change the damn power play. And after that first period with three minors and no goals to show for it. Yeah, you guys might be onto something here. Change it up. Well, in the past, we've split up our power play and it worked out. It's split right now. But if you guys want to stack it up, sure. You think the chemistry is more important or just the overall numbers? This is the forever question that we have to ask here in GM modes. Halfway through the game, both goaltenders playing very well. And that's scaring me because we didn't score in game number one and now we're not scoring again in game number two. Power play for the Tampa Bay Lightning and our penalty killers do their job. 24 shots to 16 in favor of the Tampa Bay Lightning. So Marc-Andre Fleury and our penalty killers are doing their job, but they are out shooting us 24-16. I don't like this. We got to steal this game, man. Third period underway. Come on now, Leafs. Where's my go-ahead? John Tavares, the captain, on that first line. Come on now. Oh, I was going to say Marc-Andre Fleury. That's a lot to ask for, though. That is a lot to ask. 10 minutes left. Game is all tied up at once. Power play for Tampa goes nowhere. Great kill by Marc-Andre Fleury and the Leaf penalty killers. 3-2-1. Oh, Mitch the bitch steals one late. And the Toronto Maple Leafs get themselves right back in this series. That is huge, Mitch Marner. That is a massive goal right there. Not quite the biggest goal of his NHL career last year, the overtime goal against Philly in the conference finals. But that is huge. All right, the fact that we won that game. So you can thank Tavares and Marner. So the first line, sure, but also Marc-Andre Fleury back there. Great job. Oh, yes, we stole that one. That is a game where the defense steals it, the goaltender steals it. We had those kind of stats during the regular season, and we finally got one during the playoffs. Great job. Don't worry about the minus ones. But again, Liljegren and... Shillington was fine. Liljegren, maybe they were caught in a change or something like that. So, see what I mean about not making line changes? Now, the one thing I will say that has been consistent with these lines is that we're not scoring. So, the power play is something that we can change that won't affect the 5-on-5 defense. So, I agree. Only 2 goals for in the first game, 2 goals for in the second game. We should change the power play. So, what do you guys think? What do you guys feel? Phil. Phil's got to come. Yeah. That's the one. Tavares, Nylander. Let's get Riley. What, it should be Riley or Bear. If I go Riley, I get the +1. If I go Bear, I get the worst player, but a +3. What do you guys think? Should it just be all the best players? Put Phil back on the first line. Nah, Swanby, he wasn't working out right there. Bear's been good. Bear has been good this playoffs. All right, so Ethan Bear, Johnny T. I want John Tavares. Who's better at faceoff, Johnny T or Nate? 87 for Johnny T. Nate? 76. All right, Johnny T, you're in the middle. Nathan McKinnon, that right-handed bomb. Mitch Marner, yeah, I got a lot of right-handed shots. I got all right-handed shots. That's fine, whatever. It's a simulation. McKinnon, Tavares, Marner, Nylander. I like Nylander on the wing. He does a lot more for me, scoring goals in the playoffs. I'll get Marner on the point with Ethan Bear. And then the second line, we're going to go... I need a... Who? Let me just think this out loud. I could go Robertson and Getzlaf, or Getzlaf. Getzlavian, right? Getzlaf, and then I take out. Probably if I go like, let me just try something here. So if I go Shillington, and then I go Robertson, do I get a +3? I do. You guys think about that? Now I can work better overall players, or I can try to get a +3. What do you guys think? The +3 could be nice. But then we don't have Liljegren out there. Gavrikov, it's okay. Well, it's all about the first. Yeah, we're stacking the first line. It's just about getting Riley instead of Kessel. No. I leave Kessel because he can still score. That's where he needs to be, on the power play. He's not going to be good defensively. He's only got one goal, though. But on the second line power play, he might be better. Grigorenko over Phil. Let's see what Grigorenko's done. You might be onto something there. Nah, you know, I'm going to leave Phil on the power play. He just wasn't working on the first line power play. He gets the second line now. Gets left, Puljujarvi. Yeah, you know what? I like that. Robertson. Shillington. Yeah, I like that. I like that +3. We're going to try that out, okay? So we'll keep an eye on our power play again. We're not going to change our 5-on-5. We're not going to change our penalty kill. We're not going to change our defensive core because we actually played pretty good in that last game defensively. I want to keep it the same way it is. All right, so sim to next game. It's a 1-1 series tie between the Tampa Bay Lightning and the Toronto Maple Leafs. Both teams are very similar. Which team? The Toronto Maple Leafs have come out on top 2 years in a row. Is it time for Tampa to finally win? Although Tampa did win the Stanley Cup in year number one, right? So these two teams are the two teams that have made the Stanley Cup Finals the last 4 years in a row. Tampa in the bubble, Tampa year one, Toronto year two, Toronto year three. Who's going to get there year number four? Here we go. Game number three in Tampa Bay on the road. Going to Florida, baby. John Tavares, our captain, opening up the goal scoring with the first shot of the game. You love to see it. Power play. Now, power play. Do the fans... Power play doesn't score, but I'm not going to shit on the fans just yet. They get four power plays. It's got to be 25%, right? So don't worry about the power plays in the last game. We're 0-for-1 with the new power play lines. That's how I'm tracking it. 0-for-1. All right, but we're 1-0 in this game, so that's a stat that I like. And look at the shot totals as well. 16-5. I don't know if that's just because of the one power play or what, but the Toronto Maple Leafs playing very well right now. Power play, 1-for-2. Great job, boys. Warren Fogle makes it 3-0. So the power play goal was so beautiful because it gave us that 2-0 lead, gave Warren Fogle then the confidence to go out there and play loosey-goosey and get that 3-0 lead, you know? That's a perfect power play marker right there. The second goal of the game. Jesse Puljujarvi, good job, buddy. So Puljujarvi, Fogle, that second line, Nylander, Fogle, and Puljujarvi, they're doing real good. I've beefed up the second line by moving Tavares up. I don't know how that works. It allows, I guess they're putting up the best defensive players against my first line now all the time instead of spreading it out. Who knows? But we're up by 4, baby. Going into the third period. Come on now, Flower. Flower power. See, this is what I was talking about game number one. I wasn't ready to make any crazy line changes because it was only one game. And look what we've done since that point. DiPietro's in the net. Game two, we played great defensively. Game three, we're playing great defensively as well. Marc-Andre Fleury was 5 minutes away from a shutout. Uh-oh. Steven Stamkos, wait a minute. Oh my God, you fucking idiots. Don't you dare do this to me. So the Tampa Bay Lightning are capable of exploding for offense as well. They got, within 4 minutes, they got 3 goals. Oh my God. Thank God for John Tavares' power play goal again. So we got another power play goal. I didn't even realize that. We got another power play goal there. So what was our power play? 2-for-3? 2-for-3 on the power play? Great job, boys. So the Twitch scouts got our power play working at 66%. Good job, boyos. Injured stomach. What the fuck? That's my first line defenseman with the chemistry. That is so huge. Timothy Liljegren goes down with an injury, ladies and gentlemen. All right, so let me just replace the player for right now. When did it say? The 5th? So the good news is that we have a 2-1 series lead. So he should be back. If they win two straight, he should be back by then. Hang on. Simpson next game. Yeah. Okay. So if I'm going to try... If that's going to happen... Because Ethan Bear, you two are working... Yeah. Do I give Gavrikov first line time to maintain the +5? Or do I just switch... You know what? Yeah. Lose the +3, but Morgan Riley replaces Liljegren, and then you get the +5 with Gavrikov, and that's it. That's the one. That's the one right there. All right, so we're not making too many other changes there. Special teams, power play. I didn't have Liljegren in there. No. Penalty kill. I had Liljegren. Shillington's the door. Oof. Penalty kill's getting weak. Can't change it, though. Gavrikov's the guy. Yeah. Gavrikov's the guy. 4-on-4 lines. This could be used, so I got to be careful. Riley? Yeah, no. Gavrikov and Shillington. There you go. Riley Bear, Gavrikov, Shillington, 4-on-4 continued, Zadorov, and Yandel. Because you never know, we might have some 4-on-4 hockey. All right, there you go. And, yeah, so we kept the same player types. Riley is in there instead of Liljegren, but we have split up Riley and Bear, and then Shillington and Liljegren. But Gavrikov gets Bear at a +5. Again, we don't know if chemistry works with the real-time sim. But we lose the +3, so... You know, if it works, then we lose the +3, but we gain a +5. If it doesn't work, then we maintain the same overall. I don't know. I'm trying to just find the silver lining somewhere. But the point is that we have a 2-1 series lead right now over the Tampa Bay Lightning. All right, so with the injury to Timothy Liljegren, arguably our best defenseman, right? Because he's the same as Morgan Riley. That's a big one. That's a big one for the Leafs. Can they manage the injury and still find a way to defeat the Tampa Bay Lightning? Game 4 in Florida. The difference between a 2-2 series tie and a 3-1 series lead. Now, I'm not going to get too excited about being up 3-1 after what I saw in year 2. And after what I just witnessed in round 1 for your Toronto Maple Leafs, 3-1 is the new, you know, worst lead in all of sports, I feel like. Every damn sport, you're up 3-1, it's not over. It's far from over. We keep on seeing it. So here we go, second period. Game is all tied up. I love the way our team has been playing defensively. Like, the Tampa Bay Lightning are falling into the same trap that they fell into last year. Mitch Marner, great job. And the year before that, their inability to score against the Toronto Maple Leafs. I don't know what it is. I think it's a combination of the team, sure, but also you guys. Because we're all making these line changes. And by the time we get to Tampa Bay, we've already tweaked the changes in round 1 because we've ran into problems. And then we're ready to go for Tampa. Then we tweak the power play lines. We get some goaltending and... 2-0, I mean, this is great. 2-0 lead after 1, 2 goals by Mitch Marner. After 2, right? Yeah, we're up by only 1 now. Ryan McDonagh gets his team back within 1 here in the third period. Power play for the Tampa Bay Lightning goes nowhere. 10 minutes left. Come on now, boyos. Get this 3-1 series lead here in Tampa Bay. Why not? 4 minutes. Power play late for the Bolts. They kill it off. Yes! The Baconator gets the empty netter. What a penalty kill. And what a game by Marc-Andre Fleury. The Tampa Bay Lightning outshoot us 25-17. And yet we still win it 3-1. Great job, Leafs. Great job. See what I mean? We own the Tampa Bay Lightning. We own them. They have no answers for us. None. Whatsoever. Oh my god. The Winnipeg Jets are up 3-1 over the Chicago Blackhawks. The rivalry is coming to an end. It's coming to an end. Although they have been down 3-1 before against us year 2. So simulate up to game number 5. And Liljegren's available to play. Good. Continue. I think I might even leave Liljegren out until like game 6. What do you guys think? Because we're playing well. And we still have a halfway to go in the playoffs. I don't want to have a lingering injury. I'll play him injured for game 6 and game 7, but I have a game here where we can take our time. All right. So it's not a free game. I want to beat his ass, but oh goddamn, I don't know. Hang on. Let me think. It's the playoffs, right? Worst case scenario, we lose 3 in a row. If I don't play him for one game, will I be blamed for that? No. Worst case scenario, I bring him back for this game, we lose, and he gets injured, and he's gone for the play. Yeah, I can't have that happen. You just won a game without Timothy Liljegren. Yeah. All right, I just talked myself into it. All right, so Lily is back, but because we are in the second round, we have a 3-1 series lead. I'm going to give him a game off. If we lose this one, he's coming back for game 6. All right, so here we are in Toronto, round 2. 3-1 series lead over the Tampa Bay Lightning. We've been here before. Can we get this done in a convincing fashion, or are the Tampa Bay Lightning going to play games with us? Oh, God, here we go. Nikita Kucherov opening up the goal scoring for the Tampa Bay Lightning, giving his team a 1-0 lead. Shots are even, though, so I'm fine with that. We are playing well. We are simulating well. Perfectly fine with that. All right, we can come back. I know we can explode for offense. Power play again for the Tampa Bay Lightning. Goes nowhere. Our penalty killers are doing a good job, but Victor Hedman blasts one from the blue line. Yeah, they are due. Our two teams are very similar, and Mitch Marner, remember that game where we stole game 2? The fact that we're up 3-1 in this series, it's a little bit too telling. They deserve more, so it tells me that they're going to win this game. Yeah, 2-0. And also, Vasilevsky, he's certainly due for a freaking shutout, right? The problem is that can they string 3 games in a row? They can certainly do it, and then I don't want that happening, man. Vogel gets us back within 1. This game is far from over, though. Power play for the Leafs, the new power play. No, we cannot score on it. Penalty kill. We do kill it off, giving us a chance to tie it up late here in game 5. Do we have a late game tying goal in us? No, we do not. The Tampa Bay Lightning are going to win game 5 at 2-1. Not good. Not good. All right, so we had our one free game. And you know what? Timothy Liljegren not playing didn't even really affect us, right? We played fine defensively. It was our lack of offense. So that was our one free game. All right, offense, now you guys got to step up. So edit lines, I'm not making any changes, all right? We got a 3-1 series lead with these lines. They're working for us. We just got to get a good simulation. So, who do I take out? Do I take out Yandel or do I take out Gavrikov? Gavrikov's a -1 in 4 games played. Yandel is a +2 in 9. Right? Like, do I go back out Yandel? Take out Yandel. All right, so, well, who's going back in? Liljegren. So Liljegren goes back in. Let me just change the lines the way they would be. All right. So Gavrikov, and then it is Gavrikov who comes out. It is Gavrikov. No, because we're playing Riley and Bear. So I can't put my two defensive defensemen alongside of one another. It is Gavrikov. Gavrikov is out, man. All right. So Timothy Liljegren is back in there. Get that +3. I want to go back to the same lines that got us that 3-1 series lead, man. Shillington, Liljegren, Bear, Riley, Zadorov, and Yandel. Yeah, that'll do. So Liljegren is still injured, but he's got to play. And now the penalty kill, because Gavrikov was on the penalty kill, right? Hang on. Liljegren, yeah, he's in there. Good. Zadorov and Shillington. Yeah. All right, good. So we are good to go. We lost game 5, but now Timothy Liljegren with his lingering injured stomach is back. People are saying Tavares to the first line center position. Why? Because he can win faceoffs. The sniper down, but I'd rather have the playmaker down the middle. McKinnon, he's got +2, +8. All right. I'll listen to you guys there. That might be a good idea. I'll listen to you. He's got better face-offs. If that comes through in the simulation, so be it. All right, so Tavares to the middle position, back to his center sniper position. So here we go. We had our one free game. This is the game where we got to win now, all right? If they force a game The Winnipeg Jets have defeated our rivals, the Chicago Blackhawks. I don't like that. I don't like that at all, because now, is that the signal? Is that an indication of what's going to happen to us? The two teams that have won the conference finals both years, the last 2, both eliminated in round 2? Winnipeg and Oh, God. We got to get through. All right, here we go. Game 6. Game 6. Come on now, Leafs. No playing around. This is the time to do it. On the road, no pressure. All the pressure's on them. Come on, baby. We can do it. I need you guys to step up and blast some offense. Mitch Marner, shorthanded goal. Stack the penalty kill and watch good things happen. All right. So they get a power play goal, whatever. That's free money that we're working with right now, right? House money. Beautiful. All right, good job, Mitch. Scoring that shorty. Just taking all that confidence and all that morale away from the Tampa Bay Lightning. Their captain, Steven Stamkos, tries to inject it back into the lineup, but we're all tied up at ones after one. They could have had a great period there. All right, so we're still in this game. Good. The shot totals are 15-13, but they've had 2 power plays, so I'm thinking that we're simulating pretty well. Second period, underway. Give us a power play. How about that, Zebras? Come on, Zebras. There you go. Power play goes nowhere. I'm really hoping that we can score some power play goals after we made those changes. I'm a believer. Another power play for Tampa. What the hell? The Zebras, you sons of a... The Zebras, man, they want that Game 7 ratings for the damn Toronto Maple Leafs. They're rigging it against me. Steven Stamkos. Oh, my God. Not again. Not again. I hate the 3-1 series lead. I hate it. I fucking hate it, man. Ah, all right, relax, relax. This game is, we're still in this. We're still in this. Steven Stamkos, the captain, has got his team in this, but we can explode for three. All right. We're not due, though. If we, oh, wait a minute. John Tavares, the captain, scores less than a minute into the third period. John Tavares, another shorthanded goal for the Leafs. Two shorties in one game. Ryan Getzlaf, the good old Canadian boys, will not be denied. Oh, my God. Andrei Vasilevsky completely shits the bed here in game six of the second round. Can the Leafs hold on? No, they cannot. Sorensen, he's going to tie up the game for the Bolts. What a wild third period here, ladies and gentlemen. Warren Fogel. Oh, no. Joseph ties it up again. Wow. You're getting your money's worth tonight, ladies and gents. We are going to overtime. The Leafs had it. Freaking Fleury dropped the ball on Soros and then dropped it again on Joseph. Who's got the overtime winner? Will it be for the Bolts to force Game 7 or for the Buds to get to the conference finals? Let's go. So here we are. We have ourselves overtime. Let me get rid of this Twitch chat right here. We're in Tampa Bay for game number six. It's been a wild game. A crazy third period. Whoa, what a shot by Kucherov. But a better save by Marc-Andre Fleury. The flower coming through. Flower power, baby. Top 10 in goals. MacKinnon and Tavares both tied with 8. I'm going to leave John Tavares for a defensive zone faceoff. You guys told me to put him at the center position. Here we go. Up against Braden Point. Come on, boys. Get us back to the freaking conference finals. Point back to Hedman. Hedman, Sorelli. Braden Point gets the puck poked off his stick. I think it was by Mitch Marner. Good job, Mitch. And the Tampa Bay Lightning have to reload. Off the left wing, Braden Point finds the one-timer. Skies it high, though. Shillington picks it up for the Leafs. Finds his defensive partner, Liljegren. Marner, what a pass to MacKinnon. Finds Tavares in. Oh, trying to go five hole. What a great save by Vasilevsky. MacKinnon rings it off the bar. And the Toronto Maple Leaf Stars are really showing their skill. MacKinnon, Marner in. Wrist shot. Better save by Andrei Vasilevsky. Jeez, if the Toronto Maple Leafs cannot win this series, remember those saves by Andrei Vasilevsky. John Tavares was in alone, and he got robbed five hole, man. Marner, get the puck in deep. There you go. Across the blue line. Finds Fogel. Fogel, five hole. Better save by Andrei Vasilevsky. Some great offense right there. And you know, I normally don't hit pause, but that was a great save by Vasilevsky on John Tavares. I got to show you guys that again. Oh my God. I thought Johnny T was going to walk right in. He tried to go 5-0 on. It was just such a beautiful play. Look at this. A great pass first off by Mitch Marner. That's what he does. Finds the flying MacKinnon on the wing. All right. The Big Mac. You guys were right. Put him on the wing with all that speed. Finds John Tavares. Doesn't snipe it right away. Goes in. Dangles around the two defensemen. Tries to open up the 5-hole. But no. Vasilevsky shuts him down. The rebound then. Oh, couldn't get it. Passes it out. MacKinnon. The Big Mac. Snip off the post. Holy shit. Crazy. The series continues. The series continues. I'm throwing up my second line. Nylander, Pajarvi, and Warren Fogel. Let's see what they can do for me. We know that Nylander is a good faceoff, man. Oh, hang on a second. All right, that's butter. Here we go. Offensive faceoff. Nylander back to Riley. Ethan Bear. Oh, Ethan Bear with those floaty passes to the middle. Not good. Here comes Palat for Tampa. Loose puck in the middle. Oh, Pajarvi, pick it up, buddy. Did I call him Pajarvi? Didn't mean to do that. Uh-oh. Tampa. Sorensen. In the middle. Palat. Big save by Marc-Andre Fleury. All right. I need a... I need a defensive zone faceoff, which means Ryan Getzlaf. The veteran. The big man. Getzlafian. There he is. He's so old school. He doesn't have to wear a visor. Doesn't have to grandfather it in or nothing. Here we go. Ryan Getzlaf. Face off. Uh-oh. He loses it. Foot in. Oh, Getzlaf, you had one fucking job, you idiot. And you... Oh, he misses that face off. Dansk in. There he is. Dansk with Phil Kessel, baby. Let's go, fourth line. Show me what you guys can do. Tampa Bay coming back the other... coming back with a counterattack. Centers it. Palat. Big save by Marc-Andre Fleury again. All right. To hell with this this line. Robertson, can you win a face? You know what? I got to get... You know what? Nylander again to win that face off. I have to. I don't know if Robertson's a good face-off. Well, he's not. He's my worst face-off, man. So, here we go. This is crazy, man. This is insane. Offensive zone faceoff for Tampa. They do end up winning it. Into the middle. Sorensen. What a save again by the Flower. He will not be stopped. Palat to Stamkos. Flower power is keeping his team in this. Palat behind the net. Picked up by Nylander. Ethan Bear skating it out for the Leafs. Come on, make a pass. Make up. Where's the puck? We lose it. Are you idiots? What the? Go, 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 go. Who is that? Morgan Riley? Oh, Morgan Riley trying to look for a breakaway. Could you imagine? That'd be hilarious. Oh, never mind. You don't have to imagine. Pulley Harvey cross the freaking blue line. Looking, turning. No, he gets the puck poked off his stick. And he gets board play down along the goal line. But he still has it. Centers it. Oh, man, there was a better option there in the slot. Instead, Pulley Harvey tries to find Ethan Bear on the blue line. Stamkos in. What a move. Stammer, but he's picked off by Riley. That's why I pay him $875 million per year. Fogle across the blue line finds Pulley Harvey. Tries to take that wrist shot. It's a cluster right now. I got to get a line change, but I gotta do it at the right time. I always make that mistake. Here we go. Kachuk in. Wrist shot. Oh, tries to go. Five hole. Fleury with the save. Jeez, man. I keep on getting these defensive zone faceoffs, and I can't play my first line. All right, here we go. Tavares, McKinnon, Marner. Hopefully, they can break it out for us. Come on, boys. You're up against their third line. This is a perfect matchup. And Yanni Gord beats Tavares. I'm losing every faceoff, and they keep getting shots on the net. What are you idiots doing? And then I'm losing the puck battle. Tavares, break it up. McKinnon, let's see that speed. McKinnon, cross the blue, cross the red line. He gets poked, but he still has it. Control. Tavares. Oh, he just misses the net. Johnny T takes another shot. A better save by Vasilevsky. We can't buy a goal past Andre Vasilevsky. Joseph to the Tampa Bay Lightning. He's got a wide open Kachuk and a better save by Marc-Andre Fleury. Man, these players love to try to shoot five hole, don't they? All right, if we're going to change to the third line. Oh, look, freaking hell. Just get it in deep, you idiots. Joseph. Oh, and the Tampa Bay Lightning are going to score in overtime to win game six and force a game seven. Oh, Andre Vasilevsky, you made some incredible saves. And that could be the reason why the Leafs are going to lose this year. Remember this overtime. Remember it. Oh. So game six comes to an end and the Tampa Bay Lightning have forced a game seven. And that is, it's the worst way. Because if you look at game five, we lose 2-1. It's a game we could have won. Game six, we had two leads in the third period. We squandered them both. 6-5, we could have won that one. So you got the argument now that we should have won one of those two games. And now Tampa Bay might be due for a game seven, right? People are saying that it's my fault for the bad line changes. Hey, I'll take it. Fair enough. But the line change AIEA definitely needs to be upgraded. Jesus Christ. It is horrible. Whatever. So here we go. Game number seven. I am not going to make any line changes. Our team was fantastic with the offense in that game. Great with the defense in the game before that. I just got to hope that another 3-1 series defeat or comeback is not in the storybook ending for the Toronto Maple Leafs, but you know what? I don't like the way this is playing out. It makes sense from the storybook perspective. If the Chicago Blackhawks, our rival, the team that we face in the Stanley Cup Finals two times in a row, is out in the second round, then it only makes sense that we're out in the second round as well. So here it is, all right? Game number seven. Remember all those saves that Andre Vasilevsky made in overtime, because here it is. It could all be because of that. Game seven, we have home ice advantage in Toronto. Who's going to step up and who is going to go golf? Second shot of the game followed up by a power play for Tampa Bay. Great job. Power play for the Toronto Maple Leafs and our power play still can't score. Power play again. Yo, Zebras, put the damn whistles away. Let them play. It's game freaking seven. Phil on the fourth line when you need the Cookie Monster to step up. Phil Kessel knows how to get it done. Great job, Philly. Great job, Philly. All right. Phil's old legs, it's hard to keep up with everyone around the NHL now, Phil. I know, but he still gets it done. Great job. Second period underway. Game is all tied up. I mean, this just makes sense. Although, look at their simulation. A power play, though, for us. Give us a power play goal, please. Son of a bitch, I just can't get those power play goals now, boys. We're like 0-for, I don't even know in the last, I don't even know. But it seems like it's been a while. Second period is coming down to an end. Shot totals are even, so we're simulating what? Nathan McKinnon, the Big Mac. He scores from the neutral zone. Oh my goodness gracious. All right. Now, I'm not getting ahead of myself because in the last game, we had the lead twice in the third period. We exploded, and then we had the lead twice, and we squandered both of them. Kessel and the Big Mac scored for the Toronto Maple Leafs through two. We have 20 minutes to go. This game is far from over. I'm going to need Johnny T. I'm going to need Willie Nee. Mitch Marner. Phil Kessel already came through, but I need my top six. And hell, Morgan Riley, if you want to chip in with a goal, that'd be beautiful. But Marc-Andre Fleury, this is why I chose you over Korpisalo. Times like this, games like this, veteran leadership, need you. Third period, underway. Can the Leafs hold on to it? Oh, Morgan! I called for it! I got it! An $8.75 million goal in round number two to give his Leafs a two-goal lead. Come on now, Marc-Andre Fleury. With the routine in place, power play for the Tampa Bay Lightning. It's a long one, you fucking idiots! And we kill it off. Good job, penalty killers. Good job, Marc-Andre Fleury. We're going to do it. We're going to do it. Yes! And the Toronto Maple Leafs, for the third year in a row, have defeated the Tampa Bay Lightning in the second round and are off to the conference finals once again. Let's go, boys. That's another W. Okay, so round number two comes to an end, and we have defeated the Tampa Bay Lightning in seven games. It was a wild game six, but you know what, man? Once we made those line changes in the last series, it was just game one that was kind of a wild one. But you go back to that series against Carolina, you know, all of a sudden our team is playing very well defensively. One goal against, two goals against. That was the weird game. But then back to normal. One goal against, three goals against, one goal against, two goals against in the loss. Then that was another wild one. So two out of seven games the Tampa Bay Lightning were capable of going wild with us. But then back to normal for game seven, 3-1. So I don't know what it is about whatever team comp I have. But the Tampa Bay Lightning for 3 years in a row have not been able to score essentially at will against the Toronto Maple Leafs. Maybe two, maybe three games they can score, but they're certainly not that fourth. And we're killing it, man. We're getting goals from everywhere. We're actually getting some goaltending as well. Our blue line is showing up. This is great. We could be back at it, man. Back in the Stanley Cup Finals for the third year in a row. The only problem is that we're not going to be facing against our rivals, Chicago, because they're out. It's Winnipeg and Anaheim in the West. And we have a rematch of last year's conference finals, Philly. So last year it was what? New Jersey, Tampa, Philly on our road to the Stanley Cup Finals. This year it's Carolina, Tampa, Philly. So the revenge of the Philadelphia Flyers. Oh, great. So let's see what the Philadelphia Flyers have and what they're bringing to the table here. I should have gone the other way. Hang on a second. I think they parted ways with Claude Giroux, right? He's not there anymore. Yeah, Ilya Kovalchuk at 41 is on their first line. He's a plus 13. Okay. Sean Couturier, two-way. And then Voracek, playmaker. So the two-way playmaker-sniper combination. I mean, I guess it works. I'm guessing that Sean Couturier is just really good defensively. He's got 14 points in 12 games played, though. My God, that's crazy, dude. Hassel Hoffman, Nolan Patrick, and Travis Konechny on the second line. All right, so Hassel Hoffman is a sniper, two-way, and a playmate, or power forward, sorry, and a two-way, right. Okay, so I don't know about a power forward, two-way sniper combination. Farabee, Hayes, and the real deal, James Neal, Krejci, McClellan, and Svechnikov. All right, so a bunch of like two-way forwards and power forwards on this team. They have the two snipers in Hoffman and Kovalchuk, but that doesn't really jump out at me. Defensively, Provorov and Sanheim, Gosh Despier and Philip Myers, Lazone and Vakanen. So they have their two-way defender and another two-way defender with an offensive defenseman in Gosh Despier. So they have a pretty good blue line. Yeah, I'm not like Tampa looked like a better team than this, but then Kata Hot, 89 overall. He's only got a 914 save percentage. So I wonder, because the computers get the quick sim, if this team simulates a little bit different when they're facing the other computer. But then again, it's usually teams like this that dominate me in the playoffs, and I have no reason to know why they did it, right? All I see on this team is two-way forwards and power forwards. So perhaps their ability to keep the puck out of the net and to dominate the simulation by outshooting us, you know, beating up on that skill. I don't know, though. Kata Hot, yeah, Carter Hart, boys. now, hang on, edit lines. I'm going to keep the lines the exact same way they are. We're playing very well with them. Liljegren's in there. I'm going to leave him up there with Riley Bear. And, yeah, Captain Keith gets to stay because he's a plus three, and we're winning with Keith Yandle in there. And I don't want to put Gavrikov alongside of Zadorov, and I don't want to take Zadorov out in favor of Gavrikov just because. Like, Zadorov is doing just fine. So we're going to leave the lines the way they are. And Marc-Andre Fleury, my man, you just continue to play like that. And if you can win two Stanley Cups before he retires as a member of the Toronto Maple Leafs, I mean, legendary. Okay, so here we go. Game number one in Toronto up against the Philadelphia Flyers. They look like a team that can keep the puck out of the net and beat up on us, but also a team that might take a lot of penalties. So I don't know. I feel more confident against Philly than I did against Tampa Bay. So let's see, power play for the Philadelphia Flyers to start the series off. It goes nowhere. See, that's the problem. Like, they got Gosh to Spear, but their power play is not going to have a plus five on it with all those two-way forwards. And their best snipers are Kovalchuk and Hoffman, 81-82. Remember the problem that we ran into with Phil Kessel? Being an 83 overall sniper, not being able to keep up when the real-time sim kicks in? Not being good defensively, hell, not even getting any goals. Power play goal for James Neal, but Phil Kessel answers right back with an even strength fourth line goal. Phil can get it done on the fourth line, though. Good job, buddy. Power play for the Toronto Maple Leafs goes nowhere. I gotta say, boys, our power play has been a little bit weak recently. I want you guys to start tracking it again, all right? So far in this game, what are we, 0-1? Timothy Liljegren scores. Keep an eye on that power play, because I don't think it's simulating very well, and I want to make sure that we have a good simulation, all right? I'll actually, hang on a sec. To give you guys an update, so you guys can track it for me. We didn't take any penalties in the first period. We took 1-2 with double minor. The double minor I'll count as 1, so we're 0-2, all right? 0-2 on the power play to start this game. Guys, keep an eye on that for me, if you don't mind. Yeah. Yeah, we didn't score a power play goal. All right, so we're up 2-1 going into the third period. Let's start this series on the right foot. Get that game one victory. Convincing fashion. We're out shooting them. Just need a, like, this is the problem with a team like this. They can steal it with a guy like Carter Hart. Push the game to overtime. Win it 3-2, 2-1. You know, I'm hoping that our offense can overwhelm them. But look at this problem. If they score one late here, all of a sudden it's overtime. 2 minutes left. Marc-Andre Fleury. And the Toronto Maple Leafs, good defense, show up here in game number one of the conference finals, taking game one 2-1. Good job. All right, so they did their job. Like, they did what their team is built to do. They kept when you think about it, like, we were the fifth best offensive team in the NHL. We can score goals, and they kept us to two or less. That's a victory in itself. But where is their offense going to come from? Right? Like, we have a good defensive team as well. We don't have the greatest goaltender in comparison, but we have a stacked team, top to bottom, deep as hell. So I don't know where their offense is going to come from, and we shouldn't get squashed by Carter Hart like that every single game. There's another power play. That's 0-3 to start this series on the power play. I'm not liking the power play all of a sudden, boys. That one game where we made the change against Tampa Bay, it showed up. But then it did disappear towards the end, and now it hasn't been anywhere. So Philly's doing a great job stopping us from scoring. We have 2 goals for in 4 periods. Carter Hart, 5-on-3. Oh, and they can't convert on a 5-on-3 power play for the Philadelphia Flyers. Another power play for Philly. They can't convert. Where are the Philadelphia Flyers going to get their offense from? James the Corpusalo in the net. Son of a bitch, it did it again. Why does this game like to screw with me with the voodoo? So much damn voodoo in this game, man. Like, is he in? Maybe he's injured. If he's not injured, I'm just getting voodooed up the ass again. That's 5 periods where the Leafs have only scored 2. Are you kidding me? We're going to get a shutout here in game number 2? You're going to allow them to steal one on home ice? Fans pay hundreds, if not thousands of dollars to come see a Leaf game in the playoffs and the conference finals. And you guys deliver a shutout against? Oh my God. This is what I'm talking about. All right, I understand how the Philadelphia Flyers hope to win this series. 2 goals in 6 periods for the Toronto Maple Leafs. Holy crap, that's crazy, man. So our power play, boys, our power play is not scoring. I want to change it up. I want to change up the power play because it is just not getting anything done. Sim to the next game. What can we do for the power play? The good news is that we're keeping the puck out of the net. So by editing the power play, we're not going to hurt our defensive prowess, if you will. But the power play is just not clicking. So Ethan Bear, I'm going to take out Bear. I'm going to try something with our top guys. All right. Morgan Riley instead. And Timothy Liljegren instead of Shillington. In fact, I'll go Liljegren instead of Robertson. Wait. Shillington. Or I could go Bear on this line then and just try to get like a combination of a stack and a plus five. Hang on. How do I get a plus five there? Bear, Shilly, that'll do. Oh, it's Getzlaff is bringing it down. Kessel, Puljuh, Harvey. Yeah, there's nothing I can do there. So I'll just keep the plus three then. Yeah, I'll keep the plus three. That's fine. Bear and Yandel. No. It's not the offensive defenseman. It's Getzlaff as a power forward. He's not like a Fogle or a Richie power forward. He's another power forward. But I don't have a center who can go in there. So it's got to be Getzlaff. It's all right. We still have the plus three. I just want to run with my best overall players on the first. So that's Riley. We're going to see how the power play works now. If it doesn't work, we can always go back to it. Don't worry, I'm not getting too worried just yet about this series. All we got to do, like, there's no way they're going to continue to have games like this. The Toronto Maple Leafs are going to explode, and they could have had a 2-0 series lead right now. We got one of those games. We're going to explode. All right, so there are the changes. I'm not going to change 5-on-5 lines or penalty kill. I like the way we're playing defensively. Let's see what we can... James Neal is going to take the first shot of the game. It's going to go in. Power play for the Leafs goes nowhere. So our power play is struggling here up against Carter Hart. Ethan Bear, though, is going to score 5-on-5. Ethan Bear has been a real good goal scorer for us in this playoff run. I've really enjoyed it. 5 minutes left here. Come on now, Leafs. Maybe another ball buster. All those ball buster goals came in the first two rounds. Power play for Philadelphia. So they have one to start the period here. It's a 1-1 tie. Even with all their power plays, we are still out shooting them. So again, the simulation is there, but they're a team that can steal it. I'm starting to get, if Kovalchuk scores in the power play, their power play has ended up working out for them. Where is our PP? Another power play for Philadelphia. What are we doing? Taking all these damn penalties. I'm sick and tired of watching these games getting halfway through where we only have one goal for. Carter Hart's doing it again, ladies and gentlemen. What is this that's happening? We got 3 goals for over the first 8 periods. What is Carter Hart doing? Where is our offense? McKinnon, Marner, and Tavares on that first line. What the hell? Okay. I'm just trying to think about what I could do. Third period underway. Philadelphia Flyers are on the brink of taking a 2-1 series lead, all on the efforts of their defense and their goaltending right now. We're out shooting them, but they're, look at this. Again, 2-1 victory? Come on, Leafs! 5 minutes left! Are you serious? Oh my god. See, this is the kind of team that I was looking forward to building maybe with Anaheim or my next GM mode, a defensive team. Can you actually do it? What the hell? Maybe I should spread out the offense for the power play. Yeah, because the power play is not working. I'm going to go back and we're going to go +5 to the power play on both lines. Look at this. This could be a 3-0 series lead. Like this is getting outrageous. This is getting outrageous. All right, we've got to make some changes here. So, I don't know, should I take McKinnon and Tavares and Marner back off the first line? They're not scoring. They're not doing anything for me right here. I could change everything, but then we might lose some of our ability to keep the puck. Okay, let's do one thing at a time. First off, let's do the power play. All right, Tavares, you're going back down there. Marner, you're right there. Nylander, you're right there. Phil Kessel, you're moving up. All right, Getzlaff, probably out for Pajarvi. Getzlaff out for Fogle. There you go. Oh, Riley, that's the one. That's why. I was like, what? How do we... There you go. I was supposed to have a +5, and it said +1. I was like, what are you talking about? Ethan Bear and Fogle. There you go. All right, so my first line is reunited with that +5. Then Tavares with Nylander, Shillington, and then Richie instead of Riley. Richie. There you go. All right, so our power play is back to being where it needs to be. Puljujärvi instead of Kessel. No, we don't get the +5 then. Kessel is a power play specialist. All right, so no, we're not going to do that. Tavares is the sniper specialist of the second line. I could switch Tavares and Kessel. But we don't want to do that because we want to spread out the offense now, okay? Because we're not getting any. So maybe it's Sean Couturier on that first line penalty kill that's just stopping us. Now, 5-on-5. No, I got to trust them. Because we're still playing good defensively. Now, what about you guys up here? Riley and Bear. For a game, I could do Yandle. What are you doing now, Yandle? Are you still a plus player? You're still a plus player. Nah, we're doing fine. Move JT down? No. No, because we're doing good defensively. We just got to find a way to score some goals with our power play. Offense is bad. So you think Sean Couturier is blocking all that offense? Okay. I could try that then. I see what you're saying. So then Tavares there. Nylander there. All right. McKinnon there. And then I miss out on the +5 on that first line. If you want to go back with Kessel. What? Huh? What? Now it says plus... What the... New game, new glitch. All right, whatever. Pulya Harvey on the first. So you want Pulya Harvey? So we're only getting the plus three then, right? So you're okay with that. So you just want to go with the best player. Say screw the chemistry. All right. So Pulya Harvey's getting the chance to move up with McKinnon and Marner. Tavares with Nylander and Fogle. Richie with Robertson and Grigorenko. Getzlaff with Dansk and Kessel. So look good. Phil to the third. Let's see if that helps us. Yeah, okay. Phil to the third. Yeah, that makes sense. All right, so we'll get Phil going with Robertson and Richie on that third line. All right. Defensively, I'm going to leave the exact same. I don't want to get a plus five. I want to make sure that I have Liljegren playing up there, and we'll maintain the plus three. That's a good combination of both. And then we just need offense. It really just comes down to that. The power play is the key. But what's scary about a team like Philly right now is that they're also due for a game where they score some goals, right? They've had three games in a row where they haven't scored any. So this is where it gets really interesting. So a 2-1 lead for the Philadelphia Flyers after three. The Toronto Maple Leafs have made some changes. Hopefully they can still play as good as they have been defensively. They just got to find a way to score past Carter Hart, man. If they win the freaking Stanley Cup, give the Conn Smythe to Connor Hotz. So here we go. Game number four in Philadelphia. The Leafs have got to find a way to score in the first goal of the game again. Goes to the Philadelphia Flyers. Third line, two-way forward, Farabee. Oh my God, I can't score on Carter Hart. There's just no ifs, ands, or buts about it. I can make line changes all I want. I cannot score. And where are they going to take any penalties? I changed the power play lines. They're a team that's full of two-way forwards and power forwards, and they're disciplined. Give me a freaking break. Second period underway. The Leafs go another period without scoring a goal. Power play for the Philadelphia Flyers. It goes nowhere. Another power play. Fucking hell, man. Where are my power? Another one. Sure, have a blast, Zebras. Just keep on gifting them. Oh, yeah, long one as well. Where the hell are my power plays? Look at this. There you go. Nick Ritchie gets us back within the game. Still haven't seen a power play for the Toronto Maple Leafs. Oh, fucking A. 5-on-5 goal for Konechny. See, and another power play. Fucking piece of shit. It always had to be some voodoo to screw us over in the playoffs. Three games in a row, we can't score. They don't score, but they fucking win two of them. And then here in game four, they're going to explode for offense, and we're not going to get a single fucking penalty through the first two periods. Look, I mean, look at this bullshit. Nothing through the first, second period. Look at this. Minor, Toronto, minor, Toronto, minor, Toronto, minor, Toronto, minor, Toronto. Five in a row. You don't think the referees in the playoffs will be looking for some sort of infraction from Philly to make it fucking bullshit. Here we go. Down by two, and they still have the power play going into the third period. It's all coming to an end, boys, because of freaking voodoo against a team that can't even score. My offense can't find a way at all. Another penalty. There you go. I'm on another freaking penalty. I'm on the penalty screen. Great. Good job, Lily. You're in, you dumbass. Third period, 10 minutes left. The Leafs are going to have one goal against again. Look at this nonsense. Look at this nonsense. I can't find a way to score. I can't do it. I can't find a way past Philadelphia. Look at this. Carter Hart's unstoppable. All right, all right. I'm beat. I am beat. The Philadelphia Flyers are going to whoop our ass. Carter Hart cannot. They had seven straight power plays. We didn't have a single power play that game. That's, you know, is bullshit. I'm just getting EA, but look at this series. I'm getting EA voodooed up the ass right now. This is unbelievable. 2-1, could have lost that game. 1-0 loss. 2-1 loss. 3-1 loss. Go fuck yourself. I haven't had a single game where I've scored more than two goals. This team, in the first four games, I haven't had it. Oh, it's got to screw me over. So you know what? If I'm losing, we're going to go out with our big guns. All right. Let's go. Fuck you, Pulya Harvey. You're garbage. All right, you're freaking garbage. Kessel, where are you? Get up there. Tavares, Nylander. Yeah, baby. Warren Fogle. Sure. Dansk, you're going to get a move up instead of this Robertson. Robertson's played like absolute dick. Getzlaff, you're going to move up. All right, Dansk, you're going to go there with Pulya Harvey. Yeah, Dansk, Getzlaff, and Pulya Harvey. Richie, Robertson, and Grigorenko. You know what? The hell with it. Fuck it. I'm reinstituting the freaking grinder fourth line. Why not? Why the fuck not? I got nothing else to lose. Ferland, get your ass in there, buddy. Bang. All right, and where the hell is Giovanni? I got to bring up Giovanni, don't I? Yes, I do. Yes, I do. Roster moves, bringing him up. Grinder line, we're going all in, boys. We are going all in. These Leafs have decided to not show up at all. Fine, you don't want to show up on my... When I'm on the clock, fine. I'll take you off the clock then. Giovanni, get your ass up on the team. I need the ace in the hole, man. I need the ace in the hole. It's as simple as that. Who's getting scratched? You staying. Robertson, garbage. The Baconator's been shite. But I got to keep them on the team. You know what, Baconator, you've been garbage. All right, sending you down. No waivers. No one's having any Baconators after the Big Mac is on the first line. Got to change it up. All right, they're old. They're friggin' soggy and old. All right, so let me see here. Starting lines. Ferland, Paquette. I'm going back with the regular season lineups, all right? We tried everything here against Philly, and it just did not work. All right, so plus +5 on the first, plus +3 on the second, plus +1 on that third. But we're not going Robertson. We're going Getzlaff and Danson instead of Richie and Robertson. Deal with it. Defensively, all right, Ethan, get your ass back there. Shillington, get your ass back there. Riley, get your ass back there. Lilligren, get your ass back there. Shillington, Zadorov, Banger, and then Yandel. You're out for Gavrikov. That's right. I'm going chemistry. I don't care. I don't give two shits. If I lose, I lose. And you can blame it all on me. Power play, Nylander. Not like this worked anyways, but to hell with it. I need... Oh, Richie's out. Shit. Richie's out. Getzlaff comes in. I'm going to need... Hang on. Richie's out. I'm going to need Dansky. Dansky on the power play. Let's try it. Let's fucking go, Dansk, all right? I'm going to give you the shot, my man. You're on the second line power play. Penalty kill. We're going to run with it. And goaltenders, Marc-Andre, good luck, buddy. I'm not going to blame Marc-Andre for this conference finals. It is the offense. MacKinnon, Marner, Nylander, Tavares, you four have been invisible. All right, so we've reinstituted the chemistry. We've already been down, 3-1 in the series in round number one. We're down 3-1 in the series again. What the hell is this now? The AHL lines, get the hell out of here. I don't have time for you. All right, Grinder first line. No, I'm not doing that. So here we go. Sim to the next game. We have game number 5 in Toronto with the Leaf season and dynasty on the line. What's it called? If we are unable to get this victory right here, then the dynasty might have come to an end, because in year 2, when we missed out on the Stanley Cup after being up 3-1 in the Stanley Cup finals, you know, that was a pain in the ass. And now again here in year 4, yeah, the dynasty definitely comes to an end. So here we go. Game number 5 in Toronto. Can the Toronto Maple Leafs get back in this series, or are they going to get embarrassed on home ice? Hey, oh wow, a power play for us, Zebras. Thank you very much. And we don't score, though. But Phil Kessel back on that first line. He realizes that this is his last chance. He might not be back in Toronto next year. Yes, Jesse Puljujarvi, the line changes. We finally solve Carter Hart. Can we get the third goal? We haven't had 3 goals in a game the entire series. A power play marker for Nolan Patrick, though. And Philly can just score on us, though. That's the problem. See, in a game like this where we score, Philly might be due for a goal. We did our damage to Philadelphia in the first 3-4 games. We just couldn't capitalize with any offense. So we're up by 1, second period. And there you go. See what I mean? We were destined to lose to the Philadelphia Flyers. William Nylander, though, gives his Leafs the lead again. But it's just the simulation. We can't stop them from scoring. And we're getting a game where we score, though. Hang on a second. All of a sudden. I just don't believe that in Game 6 and Game 7 we're going to have 4 goal games. You know, Carter Hart's going to answer. But all right, I'll shut my mouth. This game, it's working. Maybe the line changes again. I have been very active with my line changes in the past. The line changes got us through the Carolina Hurricanes when we were down 3-1. Could it do it again here against Philadelphia in the conference finals? All right. Okay. Up by 4. 4-on-3 power. Hey, we got a power play marker. There you go. 4-on-3 it took us to be able to get a power play goal. Sean Couturier gets a power play goal for the Philadelphia Flyers. We are up by 4. Oh, God. James Neal. 10 minutes left. Down by 3. This is what I'm talking about. See, now we get 8 goals? Fuck you, EA Sports. I go through the first goddamn 4 games and I can't score more than 2 goals. And in game fucking 5, I get 9? Where is the consistency? Holy shit! That's all the games. Whatever. Relax. Hat trick hero. Yeah, that's nice to see, but I'm still pissed because we're down 3-2 in the series, and Carter Hart, yeah, the only thing that I can see is that they are kind of not due for a game where they can't score. Although, it could just be coincidence. They could score 9 here, right? But they got what's it called? Oh, no. Yeah, they got 3 goals in the loss in game 4, and now they've had 4 goals in the loss in game 5. So they've had 7 goals in the last 2 games, right? And the first four, they were scoring like two goals, one goal. So come on, man. If we can get this game six, force a game seven, anything can happen in the game seven. Man, McKinnon doing his best job trying to will this team back to the Stanley Cup Finals. He hasn't been there just yet. You got to get by Philly, though. So game six, here it is, man. I'm not going Flurry. Too bad, boys. Power play to start. Power play goal. The power play comes through. The Zebras gift us a power play, and John Tavares scores on the first shot on the power play. Oh, my God. Oh, we take a major. Great job. Or a double minor. Oh, my fucking God! We take a double minor, and they score on both of them. Their power play has just been unbelievable in this series. Why? Oh, Krejci scores. Great. And Philadelphia here in game six. That reminds me of 2004. They're just going to take off in this game, aren't they? Fucking hell, man. I hate this. Oh, the penalties are so goddamn annoying. Look at this. Look at this. Sean Couturier takes one, the Nylander, and then Zadora. Like, fuck you two. You Oh, I'm swearing like a sailor. But these idiots, man. Oh, my God. And they keep on scoring on all their damn power plays as well. Second period underway. Power play for the Leafs. They can't score. It's, you know what? Carter Hart's been the story of this series, but also our power play compared to their power play. Their power play has dominated ours. Ours has been silent as the night. Now, a lot of our goals come 5-on-5, but still, man. Against a team like Philly with all these two-way forwards and Carter Hart, you need your power play to be clicking around 20% at least. It's been at like 10%. So here it is. The dynasty. The potential dynasty. Two-time trip to the Stanley Cup Finals. Trading away Austin Matthews. President's Trophy with Nathan McKinnon. Third period, down by two, even though we're out shooting them. How many penalties did they get there in the second period? Oh, they got one. Oh, okay. Okay, well, maybe the Zebras are being even now. So here it is. Here it freaking is. Third period, underway. Oh, yeah, another power play. 5-on-3. Have a fucking blast. Fucking power plays, man. What the hell happened in this series? Good God almighty. Oh, yeah. Just take off with the goals all of a sudden. I fucking hate this game. I hate this game. No goals for against the Philadelphia Flyers whatsoever. This team just comes in. Oh, there you go. Good job, Nathan McKinnon. And the dynasty against 7 goals against in a game fucking 6. My God, man. You guys really know how to make a great sim engine that is consistent and makes sense. Fucking nonsense. Voodoo is the reason for the Toronto Maple Leafs being eliminated in 6 games in the conference finals for year number 4. The Philadelphia Flyers were just that team that was just going to win no matter what the fuck happened. My God. My God, my God, my God. What a terrible series to witness. That was just a when I see series like this, I cannot stand it. This is when it starts to remind me of being a fucking video game. And I don't care if I'm damn swearing like a sailor. 2-1 victory in game number 1. 1-0 loss in game number 2. 2-1 loss in game number 3. 3-1 loss in game number 4. Are you freaking kidding me? How are they able to play that well defensively? My team is stacked offensively. And then I break out for 9. And then they break out for 7. Where? Fuck you. All to hell with you, EA Sports. You're god-awful. And the dynasty comes to an end.
Hey guys, Johnny here, and thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, give us a like, hit that subscribe button, and make sure notifications are on so you don't miss out on any new content. We also live stream on Twitch, where I take days off my life for your entertainment.
Sonny Gray, get out of it.
You stupid pieces of s***! I should have gone with Jose for Fernandez! Oh my God, pitching change. Fernandez, get your ass in there. Oh, I swear to God, baseball God just decided to all over me. Grand slam, oh yeah! Make me miss the playoffs with a first-ranked team. Year 2, 30 games above 500, no divisional win, trip to the wild card. First inning!